This is the Civilization 4 NLL. Welcome to the Noble Leaders League. I am Shutlike. This is the third division game between Darius I and Elizabeth. Darius I is number 12 with his 2 points. His form is a win and 2 defeats in his first 3 games. Elizabeth is number 8 with 3 points after a win, a draw and a loss. Both of them has lost Diplo to Lincoln, both have played Stalin. Darius won a conquest against the Russian leader while Elizabeth drew. Starting positions, this is Darius, let's get the resource bubbles on. He's got some clams down here, there are sugars and bananas, and he starts a nice place. Jungle is a problem though, but he does have some forests up here. He starts on the eastern part of the big starting continent with access to all of this land before astronomy and this smallish continent and some islands in the east, and also up here connected to the Arctic. Those are probably going to have to wait until astronomy. Elizabeth starts down here at the western part of a very slim part of the continent, but it is connected up here. She starts with sheep, iron, there are 2 stones actually, there is a crab, there is also a clam. A lot more green available lands appear at Darius's starting position, but we'll see how this unfolds once the game starts. And off we go. We have 1 city each with Elizabeth pleased with Darius. They're going pottery and some sailing and stuff. Both of them. Let's see who gets the second. Darius the first with Buddhism, by the way, and Darius also first to 2 cities. 70 turns, 75, 3 cities. Elizabeth is 3 cities first, and she has reached Hinduism as well, so they are in different religions. Doesn't seem to matter because Elizabeth is still pleased with Darius, and she was first up to 4 cities. 1 AD, 4 cities Elizabeth. It was 3 to Darius at 1 AD. Now we are looking at expansion, and they are closing in on each other. They are far away from having touching borders yet. 6 cities each. Let's see, they have lots of room to expand. 7 cities each. So we are just now looking at the minimap, trying to figure out when their borders are going to start touching. It looks like Darius is filling up, backfilling down in the south eastern part of the continent, and then a little bit up. Elizabeth has founded a city that is now touching the Persian borders. Darius is up to 11 cities, Elizabeth with 9. Elizabeth is going optics, and Elizabeth is going astronomy, so she is thinking about finding the new world. That could be good for her. Darius has founded another 2 cities, 14 to 12 now in the city count. Yara turned 222. Elizabeth 13 cities, Darius 15, Elizabeth is going for education. Darius is a little bit weaker than Elizabeth. Elizabeth now on liberalism as well, and she has founded the city all the way to the east, as you can see there, down on the tip of that island, the southern part to the east. 17 cities for Darius, 15 for Elizabeth now. She has also founded, and there we have the Diplo victory. It was an apostolic palace win in this game, and it was Elizabeth that got away with it. So 2 points for Elizabeth. Congratulations. Here we are, Elizabeth won the diplomatic victory in 1705. Let's look at the stats from the game. Here we are at the graphs. It is almost equal in score. In gold, we see that Elizabeth was a little bit above in GNP. In production, yeah, the tendency is that Elizabeth is above. Food, yeah, that's even. Power, Elizabeth was building up a little bit more power. Culture, Elizabeth was above in culture. Espionage was Darius the First. The demographics. Darius's numbers, he had 5.4 million in population, Elizabeth has 7.4, and she had more in soldiers, she had a lot less land, but she was better in GNP, she was, well, it's almost equal in manufacturing and almost equal in food as well. The wonders. Three wonders built in the BC era and the rest in the ADs. We see the top six city list with Elizabeth getting the top two cities, also number four, and the rest of them are Darius the First cities. Statistics. Darius built 17 cities, 4 legions founded. His current improvements, 14 mines, 12 farms, 6 pastures. He built in his cities 13 granaries, 10 lighthouses, 8 barracks, and we see the apothecary down at the bottom there, one of those. Temple of Artemis, pyramids, Notre Dame, Shwedagon Paya, and you did manage to build an academy. Current units for Darius I, 20 longbowmen, 10 workers, and 6 macemen. Workboat, 1 workboat only. You did build 17 settlers, 16 archers, 12 Buddhist missionaries, all the way down to 1 Hindu missionary down there. Kills, nothing. Losses, nothing. And we go and take a look at Elizabeth. 15 cities built, 3 religions founded, 1 golden age, currently 11 mines, 7 fishing boats, and 5 pastures. Built in your cities, 13 lighthouses, 13 granaries, 10 barracks, Sistine Chapel as well, Statue of Zeus, Muslim and Masolo, Stonehenge, Great Library, Great Lighthouse, let's go page down, and see the Colossus, the Oracle, you did build a stock exchange, and the Apostolic Palace. Current units for Elizabeth, 34 longbowmen, 7 workers and 6 knights, down to 1 workboat. You did build 26 longbowmen, 16 settlers and 16 Hindu missionaries, and 1 great spy at the bottom there. Kills should be 0, losses should be 0, and that's it. Now we need to go and take a look at the victory condition screen and the cities. First, before the cities, we have the victory conditions. You take a look at this now with the percentages, 48, almost 49 and 42. For domination, Elizabeth 51 and 28. Culture, very far away with Elizabeth, slightly ahead in the third city. Apostolic Palestine. We go to the members and we go to the diplomatic victory and we see that Darius has 7 votes that he spent voting for Elizabeth, because you do require 27 out of 27 votes to win Diplo. Now let's go exit here. Let's just go there and exit and take a look at the cities. This is the Darius cities and we sort by population. Persepolis 12 and a lot of size 10 cities and then all the way down to 2 size 1 cities. Building a lot of units here, some longbowmen, some knights, culture in Dacianus. The production, we see the biggest production city is Tarsus, and we see the culture, and we see well, everything else. You can just look at the numbers if you want to. Let's go exit and figure out Elizabeth's cities. Let's go to Elizabeth. Okay. And then we click here to take a look at the cities. Sort by population, London 14, Warwick 13, York 12. biggest production cities. Well, she has four cities that can produce stuff, with London, Warwick, and Brighton, and Nottingham. And we also see the cultural stuff and all the things that you could ever want. Spoiler alert! Results and updated league tables follows after this screen. Taking a look at the table, we see Darius is now number 13 with 2 points and a positive 3 score turn difference. Elizabeth is up to 2nd place, 5 points, positive 17 score turn difference. This has been interesting. This was the last game of the day. Tomorrow we are going to see 2 games from the second division. The first one between Gandhi and Mao Zedong, which is a real relegation battle as it stands at the moment. The second one between Isabella and Hammurabi. I hope to see you back tomorrow. This has been the Noble Leaders League. Take care for now. Bye.